My name is Tim Travis Hawkins, and I am the director of Burn It Down, the story of Woodstock 99. For me, one of the main fascinations was to revisit, in a sense, my own youth, or the sort of the time that I came of age. You know, I didn't go to Woodstock 99, but I went to festivals very similar to it. I went to Reading 2000, and at the time I was playing in a lot of punk bands, so I was in some ways connected to this scene. We always knew that there were certain bands we stayed away from, but we never expected what happened, Woodstock 99. So I think for the whole scene that I was in, it was a real shock. I remember opening up Kerrang, reading about it, and just feeling this horror that something that I was, music that I love was sort of associated with violence, rape, and everything else that had gone down at that festival. So really for me, that was a big pull. I'd completely forgotten about it until it was sort of reintroduced in my life through a clip that someone sent me of the Limp Bizkit set there. And I just felt like, I've worked a lot on themes of, the rise of the far right. Having spent time, for example, a few years ago, tracking Steve Bannon as he was going across Europe and meeting Orban and Salvini and all these guys, I'm really interested in how this discourse works. And what I saw from the way Fred Durst was directing the anger of the crowd, it really reminded me that, even though it was such an apolitical context. So for me, that was actually the moment that I thought, oh, there's something more here. There are more layers to discover. It wasn't just, oh, this festival was a big disaster, ha ha. It wasn't just, oh, isn't it ironic that Woodstock burnt down? It was supposed to be about peace and love. It was actually about, oh no, this can speak to things that are happening in our society right now. It can speak to, this toxic masculinity. It can speak to the rise of populism, but it can do it in a way which actually opens a slightly different angle on it. We're not saying that Woodstock 99 fomented, this thing. We're just saying, look, it was present there. It's been present for a long time. We shouldn't be surprised that, it's erupting right now. How bad was it? I mean, it wasn't actually a war zone. I mean, there were things about it that were absolutely terrible. There were things about it that were good. I don't just want to cast judgment and just say it was horrible. It was, for me, not just horrible. It was fascinating because of what it revealed about human nature, because of what it revealed about the times. For me, it was, actually in the 60s, there's a comparison, which is you had Woodstock 69, right? It was seen as a sort of celebration of hippie culture. And then you had Altamont, which people will see as kind of the moment when the 60s died, which was where, people were stabbed at the front of a Rolling Stones concert. And in a way, this is kind of the 90s Altamont. This is, in a sense, the way that the counterculture that I loved in the 90s, which was born with, Nirvana and bands like Pearl Jam, who actually really, they had really progressive values. And then there was a backlash against it. And so this is a sort of cycle of history in some ways. So for me, it was a bit like the death of 90s counterculture and using that as a lens to talk about that time, but also seeing the echoes within it of our times as well. And we were blessed by the fact that, it was a period where, video was becoming easier and easier to use. So we have our characters filming themselves in the film. It gives it such a sense of intimacy. We have the fact that they broadcast the entire show live. So we have all of the, the footage of the performances, which capture also moments in the crowd, which are truly troubling. So we had an incredible opportunity to give you a sense of being there, of immersing you in the festival. And, it's a film that started at the beginning of the pandemic. So we were all a little starved of those experiences, which really also, made it, I think, a real, I don't want to say pleasure, but I think one of the things that's interesting about the film is it's not just harrowing. It's actually quite funny. It's actually quite endearing at moments as well. So it's a real ride. It's a lot of tension, but I think it does also make us realize how good it can be when we come together, when things go right, as well as, when it goes horribly wrong, as it did at the end of, throughout that festival.
My name is Celia Anaskovich, and I'm the director of Burn It Down. I think as a director, I'm particularly drawn to stories that, for whatever reason, have been kind of lost or forgotten to history. They were big news at the time. They were, headlines, but we've forgotten the details. We've forgotten the meaning. We've forgotten the lessons. And I think Woodstock 99 was a prime example of this. We remember it as the festival that ended in flames. We remember burning it down, but what does that burning it down mean? We remember the destruction of property. We don't remember the sexual assaults. We don't remember the deaths that happened there. We don't remember the sort of, and one of our contributors says this, the both the kind of cultural war zone that it was, literally and metaphorically. And so I was really interested in exploring some of those themes because, you know, I often find in stories that I'm drawn to that, that stories are lost and forgotten to history, not incidentally, but because the things that are difficult about them, the messages, the lessons, are issues that we haven't figured out. And this is a time in this country, in the UK and in America and worldwide, where we are finally talking more about physical and sexual assault of women. Obviously, we've had the Me Too movement, but I think there was a moment after the Me Too movement of, good, we did it. We had the march. We fixed it. And I think it's very clear that nothing has been fixed. And we have to educate and we have to talk about it. And to be able to do that through the life stories of the people in our film was an incredible honor and privilege. Bravery is the perfect word to use. These people are... I said it in our screenings, they spoke truth to power, they pulled no punches, they said what needed to be said, whether it was comfortable for them or not. And I think, you know, I have a lot of respect for survivors who talk, for survivors who don't talk. I think it's a very personal choice, and I respect and am in awe of any survivor who chooses to share or keep their story in any way. I think a lot of the work that I do is with survivors of sexual assault, survivors of domestic violence. I do a lot of crime storytelling, so murders. And, you know, over the years, a lot of people have asked me what you've just asked me, which is how do you develop this level of trust? How do you get people to share their stories? And I think as simple as it sounds, you know, you treat someone as you would want to be treated. Whenever I hear young journalists talking about the sort of characters in a documentary, I'm quick to say they're not characters, they're human beings, you know, these are not actors. And, you know, the only thing that each of us has that's ours and ours alone are our stories. So asking someone to share their story is the biggest thing you can ask of someone. And I take... every interview I conduct, whether it's with someone I like or not, and there are a range of opinions and people that anger people in our film, and I've been asked a lot about that. You know, every single person who sits in that chair is doing me an honor by entrusting me with their story, and I just take that very seriously, and I try to convey that I will do what I hope is fair and what I hope they think is fair as well. I think that what we do for a living matters. In its best form, it matters. We don't always get it right. And we try to make a better film the next time we make a film. But I think we've seen it with Britney Spears. We've seen it with, I mean, countless examples in the past, even just a couple months. What we do can change the way people think and can change laws and can, at its best, and I think all film does this, remind you that you are not alone, that if you are a survivor, if you have been through this, we hear you, we believe you, and your voice matters. And so I just hope we can keep telling more stories like this and continuing these messages.